I can't believe that. Hi, Altrincham, how are you doing?
Say that again.
Velcro Joe, our producer, has got some new sound effects to play with, you may have noticed. So, should we start again?
Did you just say Alti? It's called Altrincham.
You're on, Chris. Should we start again?
Yes. Good evening, Altrincham.
Hi, Alti, how you doing?
We're just trying to find some new different ways how to start our new live shows, but now Joe's got new buttons to play with. It's like farting here and woohooing there. That's my woohooing! Woohoo! So as you can see, we are actually taking live shows this evening, but we'll talk to you about that very shortly.
Well, that was a bit of a weird start, wasn't it? But
yeah.
We got there in the end.
Yeah, it's just a bit, but I just can't believe it. It's all happening today. I'm really pleased we've got like the festival going on outside at the market, and that's been really busy all day and all day yesterday. And hopefully it's still going on because it's raining.
It's a bit damp out there, yeah.
Just a bit. So, you know, it's like it's all going on this weekend in Altrincham, which is really good to see. Altrincham really busy. Wasn't it? Because we went out yesterday, we went to the Altrincham Fish Bar for some chips. Yummy, yummy chips from Altrincham. Wasn't it, Andy?
It's a fantastic place. The fish is bang on. Absolutely bang on the fish there. Loving it.
Yeah.
We were having discussions about Altrincham chippies, weren't we, the other
day?
Yeah. And I quite like the Don. You're not a fan, are you?
No, the shit.
Can you say that?
Well, I can.
All right.
I work for Altrincham News. We like the fish bar from Altrincham.
Do we? Okay.
Yeah. We cool. Do, Andy.
That's cool.
Sorry.
I'm Cameron and Co at the fish bar. That's fish and chips times three. Cheers.
No, times two, because Joanne's a vegetarian.
Oh, you are, aren't you?
Just like sausage.
Fish and chips times three. And me and Chris will have the extra one.
Oh, God, it sounds like Gavin and Stacey. Well, if they're going to build your plate, just put your chips before you come out. Glad that I love Gavin and Stacey. Sorry.
Not my thing. Anyway, Chris.
Well, anything's not your thing at the moment. You just take the piss.
Don't you be surprised what's my thing.
I know.
I have very varied tastes. But that's not what we're here to talk about. We're here to talk about Altrincham.
Oh, yeah.
So, what's been happening, Chris?
Well, quite a lot of things, actually. It's just Altrincham's just been quite busy this week. Hasn't it? And it's like news have come up here and there and everywhere, you know.
Fish, chips, curry and a Vinter. Hi, Chris Ackie. He's always there on the ball straight away.
Chris.
Thanks, Chris.
You should get here in the studio, but you should be in the middle of Andy and myself one night.
Oh, that sounds a bit ominous.
Yeah, exactly.
I don't think I'd like to be in the middle of you and me. And offering a new sandwich.
Exactly.
No, I'm not so sure about that.
Live for life, it's better than that big dog we had.
What do you think I was talking about?
Exactly, I was sort of saying the live show.
Yeah, so Chris, how about it? Why don't you join us? And offering a new sandwich. No, but Chris seems to prefer fish, chips and Vinto. You remember when Vinto used to have that factory over Winnishaw Way?
Oh, yes.
Every time you went down the main road, you got that lovely smell of Vinto.
No. No, I don't actually. Unless you're at the hospital like I did.
Maybe I'm... maybe you're not old enough to... Steve Hickman says that his chips are on order from Theo's. Now that's a good thing. Theo's do a fantastic cheese and bacon burger.
That's the one near the Hare and Hounds.
That's
a nice one, that is. Oh, and then you've got the Cabin and Grove Lane. They're the best. They're the best. I used to get them quite a lot when I, because I used to live in Timperley, off the Grange Estate.
Julie is woohooing at you.
Hi, Julie.
Woohoo! We were waiting for Julie. She wasn't on the ball with the woohoo, was she? Woo! See, he did that without moving his lips.
You know, it's just...
Excuse me while I'm talking at my hot chocolate.
Yeah, hot chocolate.
Cold in here. John.
It isn't actually. You should actually have an option of news jacket. Where is it?
I'm not so sure at the moment.
Well, I know where it is.
Okay.
Right away.
Apparently we're getting radios in here, John tells me.
Yes. But we'll talk about that another time.
Okay.
After our little thing this week.
You and me are having no thing at all. I'm telling you. You'll be on Caviar next week in Bowdoin, Chris. Yeah, you're moving, aren't you?
Yes, I'm moving to...
You're moving to the posh side of Olshingen.
I am, yes.
Caviar. Shut you up. Can you tell our producer is just getting used to these new sound effects? It's, she's like a kid with a new toy. Oh, Lego! Let me have a go. Yeah, so you're a proper Olshingen boy, moving closer to the centre.
Yes, because I just live on the outskirts of... well, I'm not saying that at the moment, because I'm...
You live on the outskirts of Olshingen?
Yes.
Yeah. Okay.
But it's cool, because I just want to feel like I just want to come back home.
Ah, bless. We've missed you.
Well, because you got... Joe and Andy live in Olshingen, and I thought, well, I don't know.
No, we tried sending you away, but you found your way back, didn't you?
I did.
He even sent you all the way to Cornwall and you managed to find your way back.
Oh yeah, I've been going back in there in a month.
Hi Neil, hope you're having a good time in Cornwall. I believe that Neil went for a day or so and he's still there today.
Is it? I know. Yeah. Oh God, looking forward to going back there again.
Poor Bowdoin, Stephen says.
Poor Bowdoin, well, you don't know what they're missing. That's where all the celebrities go.
Like Todd, you were telling me about.
Oh yeah, Todd from Coronation Street. He's still walking around in sale, Sainsbury's and...
So what did he buy today? You were telling me before. You didn't tell me what he bought.
No, he bought on Friday. He bought some champagne and carver.
Oh, right. Where was that invite?
Well, no, that's what I mean.
Okay.
Yes. So that's all going on. So anyway, guys, before we start our little brief on what's happening around Olshingen, as you can see, we've added a new mobile number to the live shows. If you'd like to call us, it's 07874 055611.
Yeah. We've dropped the ball again here.
Why?
Velcro Joe, Mrs. Yeah. Producer, do you think you could reach behind you and unplug that phone that's on charge? Otherwise, we won't be able to take any calls. So, excuse me. Thank you. There you are.
Yeah, so now we've got a little phone.
We're sorted now. So, yeah, 07874 055611 if you'd like to join in. Please give us a call and tell us what's on your mind. You'll actually be able to hear the calls this time because we've got technology on our side tonight, haven't we?
We have, yeah. Yeah.
So, please feel free to do that. You were saying, Chris...
Sorry, just make sure they are really better messages and calls from last week because they were outrageous and we won't consider that again because we'll just turn you off. Thank you.
We're going to get people messing around, but we can take it on the chin.
You always take it.
I know the ways you take it.
I know, I love it.
I believe so. 07874 055611. If you'd like to call and give us a bit of abuse, that's cool.
Before you do that, woohoo! Yes, so anyway, let's talk a little bit about news at Olshingen. So, Andy.
Hello.
Let's let you do a little bit of that.
Yeah, first of all, we're sharing notes tonight and we've actually got a bit. Well, I wouldn't call that a script, I'd call it more notes.
Yeah, but we've got a script so people can see, look, see, because people like this, well, we haven't got scripts, so here you are, script.
Yeah, well, I tell you what, should we start at the top?
Yes, you can do that one.
Yeah, all right, I'll do that one. Monday, 2nd of October, our Olshingen are organising a litter pick on Regent Road and Oakfield Road car park. The idea behind this is that when people actually come into the town and they park the cars there, the first impression, because those car parks are a little bit tatty, aren't they? So we want to give visitors to Altrincham the right impression, because Town Centre is gorgeous at the moment.
Oh yeah, wonderful, especially this week and seeing everyone out, it's really good.
Yeah, so between 6 and 8 p.m, Monday the 2nd of October, if you'd like to join in this Litterpick Blitz on those car parks, you will have to register beforehand. You can email sarahw@raltrincham.org, or if you just scroll down there a little bit, we put a link on the page earlier on that you can click, and that will take you to the registration page to join in. So please do.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, I've done my bit.
Yes. Yeah, quite a lot of things. Hang on, let's have a look. Let's have a look what I want to talk about. There's been a new opening this weekend opposite the festival. A cafe called Honeybee, they've opened it. They're selling vinyls and by Abbey.
Do you even remember what vinyls are, being a little spring chicken?
Yeah, it's them black things.
That's what they
just go round and round and you put a little hoop nail thing in.
A hoop nail thing? Dear me, Chris. Yeah, you need that. That's called a stylus.
Yeah.
Yeah, a little black disc. That's what the kids said to me.
It's like a CD, but bigger.
Well, my box of vinyl underneath the bed, and they're like, Dad, what's that box of black disc things under your bed?
Oh, I used to love him. Used to do that on a Sunday night, or Sunday evening, at home. My dad used to put them on while he was cooking a Sunday dinner.
Max Bygraves. And they were in. He'll be bluebirds over.
Yeah, things like that. But, you know, it's just like... well, you know, it's just actually good to see Altrincham having different things as a cafe. All cafes are different around Altrincham. We've got so many now.
Yeah.
So the one with the vinyls, I think, will be for like people like collecting or somebody like just wants to go in there and have a bit of peace and quiet. Because it looks really good in there, very welcoming. The family of four, I think. I think you've got Abby and you've got the family there running as well. So that's at the local creation.
Central Way.
Yes.
In Altrincham.
Yes. So that's all. It's just really good that everywhere's getting quite busy, and Altrincham's actually picking up quite a lot, as we saw last week. And you know, it's just really nice people being out and about in Altrincham instead of being somewhere else. I actually think we should start charging free car parking at weekends. Everywhere, and it doesn't matter where, they've got to do it, because otherwise people are just going to go, oh yeah, let's go to traffic tent instead.
Charging free car parking?
Yeah.
Okay.
Well, it's better than free food.
Oh, I don't know about that. I don't know, there's somebody down the road here that we could ask about that, isn't there?
Well, yeah, we saw them this evening. But yeah, you know, it's...
Are you going to get me on one? I got told off earlier on today. By somebody. Well, no, it wasn't. Last night I got told off by somebody about being so brutal about this girl I was talking about, but the reality is the guy's a dickhead and that's the size of it. Would you not agree? I think one of our technology little bits is just about to let us down there, but we'll carry on. Because we're totally unprofessional, so a little bit of technology letting us down won't make any difference, will it? It'll just fall apart like it normally does.
Yeah, but this slide's quite important to a few companies around Altrincham this week from today. We've had a few meetings around different mediums and different companies like A4 and somebody from A4. So Altrincham with Anna.
Good to meet you during the week, Anna.
And as you might see, there's a few different things being added by Anna and ourselves. A4 will be getting connected to us very shortly, so you'll see a bit of their work going up.
Yeah, you will see some posts on our page that are by So Altrincham, but they'll be posted under the Altrincham News name. So, but please do go over, have a look, So_Altrincham, they are on Twitter. The website I should have researched before I started, but presumably salonfinland.co.uk. I'm sure Google will tell you.
Yeah, and if you've got, well, I actually might have, we've got, hang on. As a, well, I forgot, I'm mixing up with my words tonight, I'm really sorry.
You get your mixed all words up.
Yeah, it's better than raincoat. Well.
Okay, I'll just fill for you, 07874055611 if you'd like to give us a call. Please take part in the comments down there on the page. We can read them off here. Because we've got the technology!
Well, we have.
When it works.
If it doesn't work, but hey, that's Altrincham for you. But anyway, what's Altrincham been getting in the last 12 months, eh, Andy? Quite a lot of businesses.
They have?
We have. We've had Nando's, we've had JD Sports, we've had Miller's, which has actually just reappeared again on George Street. We've had Paper Chase. And coming to Altrincham, we've got the new Warren's Bakery. I can't wait for them. I love Cornish pasties. Absolutely love them. Sorry, but mine is me as fat. And then we've got Flannels coming to Altrincham, which is where the old new look building is. And also we had some a bit of exclusive from our page, on our page last night, which is a bit late, but it's quite strange to have a lot of people have shared us and commented on us. So I'll let Andy talk about that one. Andy, we're going to talk about that one for you.
What's about that one there?
Yeah, the new one that's coming to Altrincham. Where do you think this will be?
Where?
Yeah, you talk about it then.
Okay, we broke a story on the page quite late last night. About a restaurant chain called Tim Hortons that apparently are very big in Canada. Yes. It was Canada, wasn't it? Judging by the comments on the page after that post went up, a lot of people are aware of it. I must just be ignorant because I've never heard of them. But they're described as a quick service restaurant with a difference. And they're advertising for staff. Again, the link is down there on the page from last night. There's a link to the vacancies that they're offering. So yeah, Tim Hortons coming to Altrincham. With no timescale on this, but I don't know, the people who know about Tim Hortons seem really pleased, and it sounds as though it's, well, it's quite a popular chain by all accounts.
Well, if it's a quick service restaurant, it sounds as like another McDonald's.
Oh, I think it's a little bit more than a McDonald's, to be honest. It sounds it anyway.
Yeah, well, it's why do we need more food shops? I really do. But anyway, guys, what would you like to see come to Altrincham? Let's make it happen, because a lot of people say they want certain shops and then they do appear and then people are like, I didn't really want that. Well, now's your chance. Go to Altrincham Unlimited and tell them, because they're the people that get people to come into Altrincham unless they're looking around.
We're actually going to be running out of empty units, aren't we? Well, compared to what it used to be like a couple of years back there.
Everyone's just snatching them up very quickly. Well, if you've got friends and family that have got businesses and they're looking to come to Altrincham, there's actually about 3-4 units on the top of George Street, opposite Regent Road, and there's the old Pizza Hut place, which is actually a lot of people are talking about because people have redone that one, like they've done with Kelly's Bar. Mm. And also, Greenwoods is might be available as well because they're closing down.
I'm not so sure about that. We discussed this when we walked past the other day, didn't we? From what I remember, Greenwoods every now and again is a little bit like the works. They're suddenly closing down, and then a few weeks later, they're still going back to normal. I seem to remember Greenwoods have done that a couple of times. I could be wrong.
I've been
there forever, Greenwoods.
Yeah, I should have actually gone in there because I've got a friend that works in Greenwoods, and he likes old team news as well.
Does he? Come
yes. Yeah.
I remember getting school uniforms from there. And Taylor and Cross on Stamford New Road.
Are they still there?
They did move upstairs, but they used to have the downstairs shop, didn't they? Remember that Taylor and Cross for your school uniform?
Was it a massive place upstairs?
It was just an upstairs, just a room. It might have been where Slug and Lettuce was. That was just closed. Oh, what's going on with Slug and Lettuce? I know what was going on, actually. It was a landlord getting short notice.
A week.
To quit. A week's notice.
Apparently,
to quit.
It was a week.
Well, I was reading about it, and apparently the Slug and Lettuce apparently is described as not one of the best performing outlets of the group. So, I don't know, it's a...
Strange.
There's a lot of competition in Altrincham, isn't there?
Yeah, I'd actually like to see the Pizza Hut. That would have been good as a Slug and Lettuce.
Yeah, Amanda's telling us that Taylor and Cross are completely gone from Altrincham now.
Yeah, there is actually another school outfit place opposite the market as well on the top, nearly opposite the town hall there in the corner.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay. I'll just mention and all, just before we came live, we got a message on the page about a stabbing in, was it Timperley?
Altrincham.
We're hearing about a stabbing in Altrincham. Some Muslim guy was stabbed in Altrincham today. Do you know about that? Can you let us know? We only heard about it as we came live just before 8 o'clock.
Yeah, quite strange.
We don't like that sort of crap going down in Altrincham, do we?
No, definitely not now.
Altrincham should be a safe place.
No, and also, I was given a message by one of our friends on our committee, Val. Does anyone know a guy that's on this, or what's it called? Moss Lane Bridge. There's a homeless guy called Dean. Dean, what's his last name? I forgot. Milo or something. Apparently he hasn't been seen for like 2 months. So if you know where he is, guys, let us know, because Val's looking for him. He used to look after him.
Oh, sure.
Yeah, so... There's a bit of somebody needs to go and find him and let us know what's going on. Then we can send a message over to Val. Mm. Which is nice to people coming to us for stories.
07 874 055 611 if you'd like to call. Comments are pretty quiet again, Chris.
Are they? Yeah.
Not a lot going on. Please do join in. Give us a call. Tell us what you think. Tell us what you think here. Not seeing Alfred and Rita tonight.
Oh, yeah.
Look how Rita is. You watch this back. Where are you?
Oh. Yeah, our little friends are Dan and Shannon. It's Dan and Shannon. Dan and Shannon.
I've not seen them for a little while, actually. Dan and Shannon.
Where are you?
Oh. Woo! And Mandy. Hello. Not seen her for a little while, have we?
No. Where are you? This is embarrassing. Oh yeah, I forgot about that. Andy got stuck in the studio the other day. Oh. Andy got stuck in the studio.
Okay.
To be too...
Right, this is...
No.
This story... This story is cool to tell. Just tread carefully.
Yeah, but I'm just saying you got stuck in the studio, what I'm saying.
I got locked in the studio.
Yeah, because I was about to eat, I didn't eat all day that, and I got a phone call when I was in Weatherspoons, Chris, I'm stuck in the studio! And I thought, we got in, and I was like, oh god, then the wrong time was it. But hi guys, hi little ladies. Anyway. Woohoo. But see, it doesn't matter, Andy.
It's Kitten.
Everything comes out in the end, doesn't
it? It's cool.
Everything comes out in the end.
Does it?
Yeah. No, you know what I mean.
Anyway, stick to the script.
Well, you stick to your script. Because we work on this together, Andy. We're watching news.
We did. We did at least half an hour, didn't we?
Oh, yeah, look. So, other things that are going on in Ultraman News, we are having a new, we're having a guest in a few weeks' time, and I'm looking forward to having Mike from
Ultraman,
from Radio Wishamel, from the Chaffer General, on the 5th, Thursday the 5th of October at 8:30. And I'm looking forward to having him in our studio. It's Internet Mike, because he loves Andy with his music, don't you?
Me and Mike grew up in the same era, the 80s, so we're loving the music. Amanda! She has just been asking us why we don't do a live video from the Market Hall with everything that's going on there. Presumably, you mean in general, not just this weekend with the Harfest going on. Yeah, we've been talking about that. We do intend to get out a little bit more. We were talking Saturday afternoons, weren't we?
Yeah, I like Saturday afternoons, but that's when it's busy. I like it when it's quiet.
Getting out into Altrincham and visiting a few businesses around Altrincham to get them to say hello to you and tell them what you're about. So watch out for them, because we're working on that. Well, thank you for that, Amanda.
Thank you. we do so much, though. There's only so much we can do, and it's like we just try and spread it and spread it. And by the time Andy's upset and angry, I'm upset and angry, Joe's upset and angry, because it's like everything's gone to our heads. But we just haven't transferred that now for the next week. But even still, we're always busy, always on the go on that.
There's always something happening.
But we will try and make the market one day. But even though it's, they'll be like, oh God, here we go, this day will come, Ultraman News will be at the market.
It'll be an excuse to be at the fish bar.
Yeah, oh, I love that fish bar, I love it. We were there yesterday.
But we did, we had some chips yesterday.
Nice, actually. Yeah, it's nice, you know. It's just nice seeing everyone out and about, and in, but it was so chilled out though yesterday.
It was, wasn't it?
So nice.
There was something about Altrincham yesterday. The atmosphere was just so relaxed.
It's like one of them things. It's like you get on the phone, somebody will walk past, and be like, oh yeah, it's Altrincham. But then again, if that happened like tomorrow, they'd be like, what the hell's he doing on the floor there? There's something, you know. It's just so chilled out. I think it was the music. People are enjoying it, and you know, it's like. They had the choir on today as well in Altrincham. I forgot that choir's. Oh, they were playing the Red Peppers or something.
Sergeant Peppers.
Wow.
The Beatles.
Yeah, one of my friends that I know, Susan, she's in that band, and apparently it was quite enjoyable to be on stage today. And quite a good atmosphere. But everyone was doing live shows like Altrincham Today, Altrincham. Hail and Altrincham Live. They were doing all that. As you can see, we didn't do anything from this weekend, as you say. I was working today, so I couldn't do quite much. So I apologise for that, Altrincham, but I'm doing the live show tonight. You know. So anyway, Andy, is there anything you'd like to add?
I'm just trying to find out what the name of that band was, the choir that were doing the Sergeant Pepper's thing. I've got a post here from the music place. It wasn't them though, were they? I think
they're part of it, I think.
Yeah, so guys, I'm sorry, the name escapes us at the moment.
Probably Susan will kill me now. Sorry Susan, but hey ho. But it'll be good, it'll be good.
So
just one thing. So Andy, what's reappearing? Have you got any ideas for your live show on Wednesday?
No, not particularly. Like I said, I did a short live last Wednesday. A bit like tonight, I'd just like people to get involved. A bit of a midweek phone-in and a chat. Nothing too serious, unless you want it to be. Yeah, we were serious a few weeks back when I was discussing mental health. It doesn't have to be serious, but
maybe you should bring that back, because a lot of people stopped you at the Goose Green Festival.
It did, yeah. Really had a lot of support for the stuff I was talking about on the Wednesday. So yeah, maybe I'll touch on that again. But join me 8:30 this coming Wednesday, and we'll see what we can make of it. And yourself, Chris?
Well, this week I will be doing my live about around 7:30. It will be outside before it gets a bit dull, but even though. And also, a date for your diaries, we are doing starting a new live show for breakfast time at 8 o'clock on Wednesday the 11th of October. It will be the first one in October, and then after that, it'll be like every 2 weeks or every week. We're just trying to find a suitable place to do a live show for breakfast. But I've got one in mind, but we've just got to get our little neck
around it. Gear.
Yes,
right.
Arson to gear. To get in there, but even so, I did a live show last night from our studio with our grey back, which we might actually redo again, and might do a proper news one there. We might get croissants and stuff for breakfast from Sainsbury's in Altrincham. They've actually opened an Argos in our, you know, Sainsbury's Argos. That's just quite good actually.
We've been without an Argos for a while, haven't we?
Yeah, that's, yeah, it's sales ones, it's getting redone now too. But wonder if they'll stick around in the retail park.
We've not mentioned this, Chris.
No, as you
were you planning on not?
What day is it today? Well, it was the last day today for the Hidden Altrincham. They've been around for the last 10 days and they've done incredibly well. Spreading around a lot of art around different companies around Altrincham, like Grantees, the Two Brothers, Waterstones, they've got the big fox on the window there by Yoko, and they're everywhere with Joe Crushing. Brilliant work there, Joe. It would be good actually to see if you can do that a little bit more around Altrincham. More than 10 days, but as you see, you were at that meeting the other day with us, and we could actually help on there, Andy. Even Joe can help with us to do that. We can try and get it around and do it like a proper trail.
Yeah.
You know, do a little bit more.
Yeah, we do have some plans that we can't talk about yet, but
yeah,
we are working on a little project that will become evident.
Very shortly.
Yeah, Alex. Sort yourself out, we'll wait for you to get back to us. And that's not the Alex that some people might think I'm talking about. This is an Alex I actually like.
Yeah. Yeah, we've got a bit. I'll give him a ring tomorrow and just see what's going on. But hey.
So, the comments are still quiet, guys. Please join in. Although we haven't got a huge amount of people actually joining us at the moment, it has to be said, but even so, 07874 055611, if you'd like to have a chat with Chris or myself or even Velcro Joe. Right, let's go Velcro Joe. If she won't, there's no way she'll come this side of the camera, but I'm sure she'll shout a few answers out. Mm-hmm. Or she'll write them down on a bit of paper behind the camera there so we can read them off to you. Now she's going to write something abusive down now.
No, this is a bit annoying though when she does that. She can speak around the camera. She's quite shy.
Well, like when we took her to on the radio with us.
Yeah, it just got a little bit.
Yeah. You must remember, Joe, that writing stuff down with a mic when we're on the radio doesn't work. Yeah, the faces are getting pulled. Oh, she's not happy! Oh, she's not happy. I was sort of half expecting a run.
Right,
here we go. Here it comes. There it is!
God, what a shit answer.
We need to get some new sound effects.
Yeah.
So guys, comments, please join us, join in, tell us what you think. Being professional like we are, we'll run through our script pretty much, haven't we? Oh, I missed that!
Oh no, it's all really...
I missed that.
I was just watching your screen then, watching it back, and I thought, this is a bit slow, this camera. So it's just something that we've got, it's just... We'll share it, we'll...
Am I allowed to mention it?
No.
a little habit that Chris has developed.
Well, we've all got it now because Joe's doing it.
Joe's doing it behind the camera there, yeah. So if I do it now, then
he gets a smack.
Right. Okay. I'll just slip it in.
Oh! No, anyway, no, not allowed tonight because we're being.
I'll just slip it in here and there, and there we go.
He's doing it anyway. Yeah. So that was a little bit. So we've talked about our Altrincham, we talked about an exclusive, we talked about the shops in Altrincham. Tonight we talked about the old Pizza Hut building, we talked about the new cafe that's come to Altrincham, Honey Beat.
And if you send a stamped address envelope, you can build your own!
Yeah, and the, what was he talking about? Altrincham's festival today, which is really good for the market. And a new breakfast show, which is coming in October. We're talking about Mike from I keep calling it Altrincham Wishing Well. Radio Wishing Well.
You've got ideas of what your station is.
Hidden Altrincham and Andy's Live and My Life. So that's been our little exclusive for tonight by Altrincham News. It's always exclusive when we do it. Especially if it's like, oh, look at us, we're from this and we're from that.
Nobody does it quite like us, do they?
No, because we're
nobody does it better.
Except Altrincham Hail Live. And Altrincham Today. And Altrincham where? I've got a new one!
Do you know, if this
okay.
If this was properly scripted, I'd know what to expect of you.
Well, I'd like to drop one in.
I believe so.
Well, be careful. What happened last night on the sofa? Didn't it, Andy? Oh, it doesn't matter. She's in
here. I just want in. Do you want to put cameras in here as well?
Yeah, because I know quite a lot of stuff that goes on in this studio, when I'm hearing it or not.
Oh, you do, do you?
Yeah. Things appear in the studio when Chris and Andy are not, Chris and Joe are not here.
But the funny thing is, of course, on the security camera outside, you see me leaving, arriving and leaving on my own.
Well,
Andy, there is a ghost in here.
It's called Joe. Joe the ghost.
It is a bit spooky. Especially the last few Wednesdays when I've been here on my own. Katrina! Where have you been? We're nearly done.
Katrina.
Yeah, Katrina.
Oh, Katrina! Yeah, don't forget. Yeah, we're going to meet our little Katrina soon.
Yeah, Katrina, let me ask you something. When we're... Not that we talk about you, just general, but we refer to you as Cat. Is that okay? Are you a Cat or are you a Katrina?
I can't say Katrina properly. Katrina.
Say it again.
It's Catherine, isn't it?
Katrina.
Was it Trina? That's why I call a cat, because I can't announce it, sorry.
So, are you a cat, a Katrina, or...?
Yeah.
Say it again.
Trina.
Say, Altair.
Altair.
Oh, you've got that one.
Altair. I love Altair, I can't wait for them to appear.
Have you seen that, I walked past today, have you seen that picture on the hoardings outside of that little veranda thing going on with the view? Well, I guess that looks. I want one of them. I've got to get me one of them.
What's one of
them? Well, one of them little altar things.
So one of them rooms?
Yeah, I want one of those altar apartments. So please visit our crowdfunding page.
Oh, wow, that'd be well. Imagine that. I've actually messaged them by page myself. We've got an exclusive. You're talking. Oh, that'd be well, man. Better than the HQ. Anyway.
So, yeah. We're still looking for help, aren't we, Chris?
Yeah.
With all this that we're doing. What do we need? Where do we need the help?
We need a new... we don't need a new, but we need a printer. If you've got an actual good printer that they are throwing away, or you know that somebody's thrown a printer away, let us know and... we can come and pick it up or drop it off. We'll just give you a little donation. Or if you've got some carpet, it doesn't matter what colour it is, but pink, we'll have it. If it's 10 by 12 or something like that size, just let us know.
Yeah, because it's a bit echoey in here. We need a carpet. But we're skint, you know, we're doing this out of our own pockets, and they're not really deep, are they? I know mine certainly aren't.
Well, they're not at the moment, because,
no.
You know, but hey.
So we're relying on you guys to support us, to support Altrincham, because that's what it's all about.
Yes. Yeah, it's just, we try and do everything. It's like the uniform I pay for, and well, we've all paid for at the time. But Andy will be getting a new uniform very shortly.
What?
Yes, because I've just got an idea in my head.
Oh, okay.
Yes, because it's winter and we need our uniforms.
Are we having onesies?
Shh!
Nice big onesies.
Yeah, black and white ones, like a cat, meow. Post on that. This black and white plaid. I'm not doing that now. It's...
Keep what? Up.
Am I?
Now then, what's this I hear about you being a naughty little boy?
Well, that's you. Especially when I get phone calls and I'm going, I'm in the studio!
Yeah, when I get locked in the studio. It's that ghost.
Yeah, I just still couldn't believe that day. I was effing and jeffing all the way here.
And when you got here, I didn't need your help.
Yeah, I just got right out there and I was like,
Chris, I'm locked in the studio.
I wouldn't even know nothing about it.
I wouldn't mind, but they were sat in the office down there and they heard the banging and the shouting. God knows what they thought we were doing, but they thought it was just normal.
Yeah, but the thing is though, it was between two you and two ladies. So what was going on there, Andy? I got a phone call. Hi Chris, I'm just stuck in the studio. I was like, okay. Then I got here and it's like, and it, a certain person came to the door, they sucked the door out, I went outside, I came outside.
I'm trying to imagine it from your point of view.
It was nasty.
Getting a phone call saying that I'm, listen Chris, listen mate, I'm kind of stuck in the studio with two increasingly irate ladies. Anyway, these things are something to try, aren't they?
Yeah, but it's just a shame that... Oh yeah, I've got a present for you next week as well that you've got to give to a certain person back as well.
Oh, okay.
And it's quite big.
Ooh.
Actually, no, I could use it in the studio as our... Actually, yeah, that could be a good... No, actually, no. Not allowed, actually.
You not?
No.
Oh, okay.
Otherwise, I'll come and put it in that big... God. Anyway, Andy.
Yes, Chris.
It is actually just got nearly quarter to, and I think we should... leave Altrincham because let Altrincham have a good evening.
I think we've abused them enough, yeah.
Yes.
You okay?
Yes.
So, I will see you guys again, 8:30 on Wednesday.
And I'll be back on Thursday at 7:30. But before we go, thank you very much to everyone and we hope you have a lovely week ahead. So, before we go, we're just going to leave you with a little bit of a tune and we'll turn off. Good night, Altrincham.
See you later, guys.